Hello. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the new Stick Contour node in order to automatically close lips and eyelids on your blend shapes, and also to improve the sticky lips effect on your 4D animation sequences. Alright, let's go ahead and start with an empty project. Let me load a blend shape from our gallery. First, we need to take a semi-open mouth expression, so we can see the interior part of the lips. Then let me create a Select Points with Splines node. Now we can go here, zoom into the lips, and start selecting the upper lip contour. That is going to be the sticking contour for our lips. Then we can copy and paste this node using Ctrl-Shift-V, and let's draw the lower lip contour, starting and ending with the same points. Then we can delete the upper lip contour. The upper lip is now selected with one spline, and the lower lip with another. What we can do is to create a newly added stick contour node. The first input is going to be our reference blend shape, with a semi-open mouth. The second input is going to be a new blend shape that we're going to close the lips on. So for this case, let me create another low geom node. Then I can go to the gallery, and inside the gallery, I'm going to select all the blend shapes that we have here. So let's choose on the timeline some nice blend shapes where we can try out our stick contour node. For example, this one. So let's plug these blend shapes into the second input. Let's plug the first spline into the next input, and the second spline into the following input. And there we go. If we look at the result of the stick contour node, you can see that the lips are now closed. So let's go to the Node Editor tab. And here you can see that by moving this slider, we can adjust the effect of the closeness of the lips. We can also adjust the deformation radius, which is currently 1 cm. So if we increase it, you can see that it basically makes the area of stickiness effect bigger. But for now, let's leave it at 1 cm. But what's even cooler about this node is that it works in 4 different modes. And for now, in this tutorial, we're going to cover just the first 2 modes, and the rest we will cover in the other videos. Let me change it to the second mode. This is the stick by distance mode. In this case, as I start increasing the stick distance, it will create sticky lips effect. And this is how you can do the sticky lips effect on your fax expressions without having to manually sculpt it. And we can also change the effect of the fall off of the stickiness using this parameter. And depending on that, the sticky lip effect will be more wide or more localized, like in this case. So that's how it works. Let's take a look at another example. For example, this frame. And again, if we change the stick distance parameter, you can see how we can change the stickiness. Please be aware that the stickiness is happening exactly along the contour that was selected by the splines. So you can see it perfectly zips this very contour. In reality, sometimes it does not lead to a good effect, because the contour where the lips are usually stuck may be different. For example, if you do a bite lip expression or a funneler expression, the contour is not going to be the same for the stickiness, and we can account for that. So let's go to another frame. In this case, you can see that the stickiness is happening in the wrong position. I'll go to the Visual Editor tab, and here we can see that this is our sticky lip contour, and it's going to stick this spline to this spline, and it's not going to work well. So what can we do here to fix this? Let me first go to the open mouth expression. In our sequence is frame 28. Alright, if we go to the Visual Editor, we have 2 options here. The first one is to just use this contour as it is for the sticky lips effect. Doesn't always work though. The second option is to switch to the offset trace mode. So in this mode, we take this red contour in the rest position and we start shifting it down into the lip some distance. You can change this distance using this slider. In this case, I would prefer to use a half centimeter. And we push this contour inside the lip. So, as we go back to frame number 27, and it deforms this contour with the lip, so it always tries to stay inside the lips. And then it basically connects the corresponding points of the contours with the straight line. Then it will use the sticking contour to make the sticky lip effect. And this contour is normally the proper contour to use for this effect. It's very important that the deformation of the offset contour is smooth and has no artifacts. If it happens, try to increase the offset lattice radius middle parameter and the offset lattice radius corner parameter. So again, if I switch back to the original contour type, the result is going to look like this. If I switch to the new contour type, the found contour is going to be much better. Let me try it using manual mode. If you switch back and forth without it, it's going to look like this. And with the new contour type, it's going to look like this. The sticky lip effect is minor here because the lip's already closed. We can go to another frame, say frame number 22. And again, you can see that if I turn it off, you can see that for the lower lip, the contour is the default one, which doesn't look great. And then, if we switch to the new contour, it's going to be shifted inside the lip, where it pretty much should be. So if you change the sticking distance, the lip contour is going to be sticking in a more correct way. As I mentioned, we have several ways of using this sticky lips effect. First, a very obvious one is to fix your fax expressions without having to manually clean it up. For example, if I go to this frame, you can see that the lips are not completely closed in this expression. So what we can do instead, we can just go to the stick contour node and switch it to manual mode with the stick value being at 100%. It basically sticks our lips automatically and you don't have to clean it up manually. We can also do the same for the eyelids. To do that again, we can create another select points with splines node. We can use the same rest pose. Let me go to the eyes here and I will start selecting the upper eyelid contour. I'm going to copy the select points with splines node and I'm going to select the lower eyelid spline from the same starting point. Let me delete the upper contour here. So here we have the upper contour and the lower contour. Let me create another stick contour node, but this time for our eyelids. I'm going to plug my rest geometry into the first input, my current shape into the second input, my upper eyelid contour into the next input, and my lower eyelid contour into the next input, and it will automatically close the eyelid for me. I can control the closeness effect by changing the stick value parameter. So in reality, if we take a look at, for example, this frame, you can see that the fax expression is not perfect because it's not closed. So we can simply use the stick contour node to automatically close it. Even more so, it will try to perform the closeness more evenly for the eyelid. And if we switch to another frame, for example this one, we want to close the eyelid here. Again, we can go to the contour node and just simply close it without any kind of manual cleanup. Another very good use for this tool, among other applications, is that we can use it to improve the sticky lips effect on our 4D sequences. To do that, let me create a new project. And let me go ahead and load the animation from our HMC gallery. First, I'm going to bring in my neutral model here. This is my neutral model. Next, I'm going to bring in the facial animation. and you can see our 4D sequence captured from the HMC. Now what we can do is to select the sticking contour here. In order to select the lip contour later, we must first open the mouth. To do that, I'm going to use a brush node. Let me switch the symmetry to topological and enable use geodesic distance. I will open the lips by using a move brush. Also, let me use the relax brush on the lips. Right, now I'm going to click accept. Then I'm going to create another select points with splines node. Then let me select the upper lip contour. Now I will do the same for the bottom lip, so I'm going to copy the Select Points with Splines node, and I'm going to select the lower lip spline. I will also add a couple of points here. Let's not forget to delete the upper lip contour. I will create another stick contour node. I'm going to plug my rest pose into the first input. Then I'm going to plug splines for the upper lip and the lower lip into the contour points input. And I will plug the frame from the sequence into the second input. Let me switch the mode to stick by distance. And let me also change the contour type to offset trace. And now if we switch the stick counter result, you can see that it creates a nice stick ellipse effect. So I can increase the stick distance parameter just a little bit, like that. Let me create a transform node and bring in my original mesh next to my new one. Then I will change the view mode to orthographic. Now, if I start playing the sequence, you can see that it starts creating a nice sticky lips effect. This one is probably too much, so we can decrease it slightly. And again, you can see that it creates a pretty smooth deformation for our frame. We can also go to another frame, say like this one. And you can also see a pretty cool lip stickiness effect. So, obviously yes, it's a fake effect, but sometimes it may be very handy. So that's basically how it works. It helps us to close the lips when they are not perfectly closed on the captured sequence. And please note that it doesn't affect the rest of the expressions. So, this is how it works, and we will tell you about the other two very cool modes of the stick contour node in the next tutorial. So stay tuned and see you in the next video.